Herzlich willkommen zum IBC Report 2014 von digitalschnitt.de Magic Multimedia.
Wir sind nun am Stand der Firma Metus und Metus ist ein Hersteller eines Media Asset Management Systems. Media Asset Management Systeme, kurz MAM, benötigt man, wenn man viel Videomaterial hat, was organisiert werden muss. Typischerweise kommt es bei Fernsehsendern zum Einsatz, aber auch bei Industriekunden, die einfach eine große Menge von Material haben oder für einzelne Filmprojekte, beispielsweise Dokumentarfilme, um die Übersicht nicht zu verlieren. Die einzelnen Filme können verschlagwortet werden, also man hat Zugriff auf die einzelnen Clips, man kann Beschreibungen eingeben, man kann Filme und Material suchen und man kann im Netzwerk, also mit mehreren Anwendern zusammen an einem Projekt arbeiten. Wir finden die Lösung von Metus sehr interessant, denn hier gibt es ein Plugin für Edius, eine sehr gute Integration und die wollen wir uns jetzt mal zeigen lassen. Bei mir ist Olga von der Firma Metus und ich werde jetzt auf Englisch umschalten, damit wir uns entsprechend unterhalten können. Es werden aber deutsche Untertitel eingeblendet. Olga, can you tell us a little bit about your media asset management and the integration into Edius?
Yes, of course. It will be my pleasure. What we are seeing here on the screen, this is the panel of the Edius. You're recognizing it. This is the Edius Analy. And here what we have is a viewer inside of our MAM. So this is something like small view of the MAM. On the left side we have the bin structure. So in our MAM the bins are same like Windows folders, but they only exist inside of the MAM. So with double click on the folders, on the bins, we can practically enter and see all our videos. So here they are. We have a list of the archived videos that we have, assets, not only videos, assets that we have inside of our MAM. And really easy, with only drag and drop, we can import inside of Edius and do all the editing. So this integration helps the Edius users to have really fast access to all their assets. So this is the view. So practically we were seeing this tree. As I said, these bins are making our end clients to manage their assets really easy and categorize them and organize them inside of the MAM. I can show a simple workflow. With the right click here, we can archive a file or a folder. And also with the use of dynamic bin, this is the dynamic bin, we can say simple, like, everything that I will put, let's say for this Windows folder, everything I will put inside of this Windows folder, I want to be automatically archived inside of our MAM. So, if I'm starting with archiving one asset, I'm saying like, okay, I'm gonna put this inside of my MAM, and then I'm gonna do the editing inside of my Edius. So, you see, it's really simple. Everything that is outside of my MAM can be really easy imported with the project properties. I can do everything on a project, not on an asset level, also I can do on a project level. So I can make my MAM to be automative. Like I can say, okay, everything that I will put inside of my MAM, I want to be in this type of format. And also we support any type, almost any famous, let's say, format type in the world. So with the help of the information lifecycle and the project properties, I can make everything on the project level. So I will not do by step by step doing everything to my assets. I can make on general on a project, so it will be really easy and simple. This is really good. This is the viewer, the MAM viewer, that will allowing the clients to see, to play the proxy or to play the high-res. So not only I'm able to archiving my and transcode my assets, I can also view them inside of my MAM. I can do some basic trimming, cutting, editing, joining, putting some margin in and out points, and also I can do some sensors. What But it's also important because that is the life cycle of the asset. After archiving, as I need, maybe I have some metadata, but I need to enter more. That's why Metus has predefined thousands of metadata fields. So as you can see by yourself, here I have thousands of predefined metadata fields. And even if these ones are not enough for the clients, there is the possibility to make your own. So you can make customized fields.
So this kind of metadata is used then to find clips and you'll be able to sort them, to organize them.
Yes, of course. Metadata is the most, maybe the most important thing about the asset is data about the data. It's giving information about the asset, and with the help of this predefined, it can be really easily managed because we can easily search our assets through the four types of search.
Can you show us the search function inside EDIUS?
Of course, we have this search. Yeah, this search is simple search, and we are saying that it's like it's Google based. So I'm writing letter A, and if the title or something in the metadata of my asset contains the letter A, it will be shown. The second type of search is advanced, is using the metadata as criteria. So I can select from my, let's say I can make or and criteria, and I can say, okay, if modification date like is yesterday, give me all the assets, or give me all my assets from yesterday or from the previous year. So having this type of criteria, I can find anything inside.
And the search function is the same inside EDIUS. Can you show it in the plugin structure?
Here. The search over here is also you can use the search model, the search method. So it can be partial search or it can be full text. So it's Google based, and I can select from what I want to search, from video, audio, document, image, data, sequence. So again, it gives us really easy way of searching and going through all our assets. So we can be really able. Also here, as you can see, we are seeing these are search bins, and we can create new search bin. Like edit this week, this is large assets, most viewed, and on the right click, I can create a new search bin. Let's show you. Okay, it's really easy. So here I can make a filter bin and I can name it, I don't know, 2012. Sorry, I need one more. Okay, so creating this and giving the criteria creation date to be equal, right? 2012. So it will give me every assets that are created from 2012 up to now. So I can see the same bin here, and I can drag and drop it, and it will be really easy for me to find my videos.
And now you made something like a dynamic search. So this means if the assets change, or if you have new assets, the system will automatically show in the search folder the new files which have been added.
Yes. Everything is updated and is up to last. So every change I'm going to do, it will be shown here on this panel. And also, if I make dynamic bins and I'm playing play in that moment, that means everything that I'm putting inside of my folder, it will be updated. So it's.
So a typical way would be that one person is doing like titles or clips or something, putting them into the media asset management. Another person is cutting, and so when the files are ready, they will automatically show here in these folders.
Why is that? That's why I would like to show you this image, because the Metus client is totally different from the archive server. So we have many clients, and we have one archive or two archive servers, and at the same time, same desktop clients can communicate with single archive server. So they can do the same things on a single asset. So assets are not locally in our workstation, they are in the server, archive server. So whatever I'm doing to that asset and my colleague is doing the same, the changes will be in the same time. This is what is good about the MUM. We can do the same things. Also here, we can do the editing on the proxy and then apply it on the high-res. No need to retrieve the high-res and to wait for a long time. So we can make the changes on the proxy and then mirroring them.
Can you tell us a little bit about your customer? Who is using this?
Yes, so our products, not only in the MUM, also other products, are used not only in the broadcast industry. We are really spread, and we have clients in healthcare, in law enforcement, in education, in fashion, also in different types of industry. What now we have, and it's really good, we have a compact, not small, let's say compact version of our MUM Enterprise. It's called Media Cube. This is our new product. Exactly, it's not new because it's derived from the core and tested and proven Metus MUM Enterprise. Mm-hmm. But yeah, it's by features, we cut it down and we make it cost effective for small customers, like small TV stations, small to medium TV stations, small private businesses, corporate, private companies, non-profit organizations, I don't know, house of worship maybe, also different hospitals, university.
Everywhere where people have a huge TV amount of media, okay.
Yeah, so the Media Cube is...
Yeah, do you have some price informations? I guess this low price or lower price area would be very interesting because, you know, Grass Valley also offers K2 servers, but they start at about 100,000 euro.
Yes.
So there is a solution like this from Grass Valley, but it's very expensive and you can offer something which is much cheaper.
This is really good. As a salesperson, I was really happy when I understand the prices of the Media Cube. So Media Cube is starting from 1,000 euro. Yeah, 1,000 euro. And there are 5 packs. So there is the minimum one costs 1,000 euro. And the most expensive one, I think, is we have 5,000 euro for 50 or 100 terabytes, something like that. And we have 9,000 euro. Yeah.
So it depends. It depends how many users and how much media.
Yeah, needs to be archived. So this is the only two criteria: the number of desktop clients and the number of terabytes that needs to be archived.
And when you have something like 5 terabyte, and then you need an upgrade, you can easily buy an upgrade.
Go from the next, you will go for the next package. Mm-hmm. Like if I bought a pack that cost me 1,000 euro, and I want to have now, let's say 20 terabytes, I'm gonna pay additional one. I will pay the difference between the next level pack. So it's really cost effective.
If somebody,
and everybody can afford it.
If somebody is interested in the solution, is there something like a trial version, or how is it possible that people can test it?
Yes, we do live demos. We are not. We don't have demo version that we are sending a link installation because it's. We don't think that that is the right way. It's not so simple solution. We want to in detail present what the MUM can do because not only the Media Cube and the Enterprise both are really powerful solutions. They are not doing archiving, as I said. They are doing also transcoding, and that's why we are doing live demos. So anytime they can contact us on our website and we can give them a live demo.
We have had Metus also at our Digitalschnittmesse this year for the first time, and we could learn that there are quite many customers interested in the solution of media asset management and the integration in EDIUS, but also Adobe Premiere and others. And so we will continue to work together, and the possibility to get a demo is then also possible at our facility, so that we can show the product to people which are interested.
That is something that I really am happy about it, that all customers can come and visit you and can get the live demo from your site.